What's up guys, Sal here. So currently, Samsung doesn't throw the full weight of the company behind its own SoC division, instead splitting the world distribution between Exynos and the Exynos division's biggest SoC rival, Qualcomm. Just last year, Samsung used to lag behind Qualcomm in chip performance, but today the two companies are even when it comes to CPU technology, because now they both use off-the-shelf ARM designs. But Samsung still lacks in graphics since they use off-the-shelf Mali GPUs, while Qualcomm has its own graphics division called Adreno. So to improve the graphics performance of their smartphones, Samsung is collaborating with the graphics chip powerhouse AMD. Ever since this collaboration was announced, we've been getting quite a lot of updates, including leaked benchmark scores that reveal not only this chip has multiple times better graphics scores than Qualcomm's latest Adreno, but also has better scores than Apple's latest A14 Bionic chip. We know that the Galaxy S22 will most likely be the first smartphone to have this chipset. Just a couple of days ago, we also get to learn that Samsung's laptops will also use the new graphics from AMD. But there's a question a lot of you have been asking lately, is that whether or not Samsung's Galaxy A range of devices would also get the AMD GPU, or is it only exclusive for their flagships? Well, we finally have an answer for that. According to the latest rumor from South Korea, the AMD GPU isn't just exclusive to their flagships, but their mid-range Galaxy A series devices will also get it as well. Apparently, Samsung will include the Radeon graphics from the Galaxy A40 series to the Galaxy A70 series, which means expect the Galaxy A43, A53, and A73 to have AMD GPUs next year. The rumor also mentions that the GPU performance is very significant compared to the current lineup of Galaxy A variants. Samsung is said to be adjusting the number of units and clock speed of the chipset for various price points. I mean, you're not gonna get the same graphics performance on a Galaxy A phone that you get on the Galaxy S flagships for obvious reasons. By the way, Ice Universe has also mentioned that Samsung will launch three new chipsets this year, Exynos 800, 1200, and 2200 series, and it seems all of them will have graphics from AMD. But this also raises another question, that will any of this change Samsung's SoC distribution plan? I mean, major markets like the US, Canada, China, Japan get Qualcomm Snapdragon chips, while Europe, India, and the rest of the world gets Exynos. Samsung has yet to indicate that it wants to switch to Exynos everywhere, and doing so would be a major upheaval in Samsung's product line, manufacturing capabilities, and in the SoC market at large. With that said, there was a report that Samsung will include a sensor on the Galaxy Watch 4 and Watch Active 4 that will read users' glucose level in a non-intrusive manner, meaning this technology could allow for accurate blood glucose level readings without having to prick the patient's fingertip, which could have been a game changer for prospective buyers who might be suffering from diabetes. But it looks like that will not happen for now. The Watch 4 and Active 4 will not have the sensor, according to the latest information from South Korea. By the way, unlike in the past, Samsung will launch the Watch and Active series at the same time at the Unpacked event in August. And Samsung is changing the dimensions of these watches. The Watch 4 will increase in size, while the Active 4 will decrease in size ever so slightly. Both of them will feature Google's Wear OS instead of Tizen. Of course, do consider subscribing for all the latest tech news. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.